Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on general method in backtracking. So backtracking is one of the important algorithm design technique. In the previous videos, we are already discussing about the algorithm design technique. One of the technique is divide and conquer technique. Another technique is greedy method. Next, another technique is dynamic programming. Now we are using another algorithm design technique method. So backtracking is one of the important algorithm design technique. So the term backtracking was defined by D.H. Lemmer in 1950s. So in 1950s, backtracking was developed by D.H. Lemmer. Next, why we are using backtracking algorithm design technique? Many problems deal with searching for a set of solutions or ask for an optimal solution by satisfying some constraints. So at that time, we are using backtracking. Okay, so we can take n number of problems. So to solve that n problems, we have n number of solutions are there. Or sometimes, so n problems can be solved by using n optimal solutions satisfying some constraints. So at that time, backtracking technique is used. Okay, sometimes it may ask the optimal solutions. Sometimes it may ask n number of solutions for a given problem. So at that time, backtracking was used. Suppose we can take one problem. So that problem can be solved by using n tuples. That is x1, x2, x3, xn. So each xi can take on some values from a given set S. So for example, so xi greater than or equal to 0. So xi can take values from a given set S, where S defines set of all non-negative real numbers. Set of all non-negative real numbers. Among, we can consider this set, S. S defines set of all non-negative real numbers. So, xi can take any value from the given set, S. So, for example, we can take four queens problem. So, in four queens problem, we have to place four queens in 4x4 chessboard. So each column contains only a single queen. So here S defines S is equal to set of 1, 2, 3, 4. So here 1, 2, 3, 4 are the column numbers. So Xi can take only one value from a given set at a time. Suppose xi is equal to 1. x1 is equal to 1. That means the first queen can be placed in the first column. So xi can take one, x1 can take one value only from the given set. Yes. Next time x2 is equal to 2. So that means second queen can be placed in second column. Next, x3 is equal to 3. That means third queen can be placed in third column. Next, x4 is equal to 4. That means fourth queen can be placed in fourth column. Now, all the values in the set S is completed. So, xi can take either one value or two value or three value or four value. So, that is the explicit constraints. Okay. So, So every problem, so at that time we are using backtracking. So suppose we can take a problem. So the problem can be solved by using a n tuple, that is x1, x2, x3 up to xn. Each xi to take on values from a given set, yes. So at that time backtracking technique was used. All the problems that can be solved by using backtracking technique, so it can satisfy two constraints. First one is explicit constraints, second one is implicit constraint. So explicit constraints are the rules which restrict each xi to take on values from a given set, yes. So these are the examples for explicit constraints. So which restrict each xi can take values from a given set, yes. So every time xi can take one value, so that value can be taken from set, yes. Compulsory, it can take the value from a given set, yes. Suppose s is equal to set of 0 comma 1. So here xi can take either 0 value or xi can take either 1 value. Next, all the explicit constraints depends on the particular instance of the problem being solved. So which problem we are solving, so based on the problem, explicit constraints are dependent. All the tuples that satisfies the explicit constraints defines the possible solution space I. Next, second case is implicit constraint. So implicit constraints are the rules. Rules that determine which of the tuples in the solution space satisfies the criteria function. Implicit constraint are the rules that defines which of the tuples in the solution space satisfies the criteria function. Suppose, so xi is equal to, so 2, 4, 1, 3. Suppose xi is equal to x suffix I is equal to, sorry. So x1 comma x2 comma x3 comma x4 is equal to 2 comma 4 comma 1 comma 3. Suppose one problem can be solved by using four tuples, that is x1, x2, x3, x4 is equal to 2 comma 4 comma 1 comma 3. This is the solution for four queens problem. So here four queens are there. Four queens can be placed in 4x4 chessboard. So the first queen can be placed in second column. The second queen can be placed in fourth column. The third queen can be placed on first column. The fourth queen can be placed on third column. Suppose this is 4x4 chessboard. The first queen can be placed on second column. The second queen can be placed on fourth column. The third queen can be placed on first column. The fourth queen can be placed on third column. So here implicit constraints are the rules that defines that defines which of the tuples in the solution space satisfies the criterion function. That means in the four queens problem, the implicit constraints are no two queens are on the same column, no two queens are on the same diagonal. So we are considering this one. So no two queens are on the same column. Q1 is there at second column. Q2 is there at fourth column. Q3 is there at first column. Q4 is there at third column. That is, no two coins are on the same column. So that satisfies the this implicit constraint. Second one is no two coins are on the same diagonal. So Q1 diagonal is this one and this one. No two coins are there. Next, this diagonal, no two coins are there. This diagonal, no two coins are there. This diagonal, no two coins are there. Okay. So here, the implicit constraint in four coins problem is no two coins are on the same column. No two coins are on the same diagonal. Okay. So these are the examples for implicit constraint in four coins problem. Okay. So generally, backtracking solves three types of problems. First one is enumeration problems. Second one is decision problems. Third one is optimization problems. In enumeration problem, we can solve all possible feasible solutions. Okay. Suppose we can take a problem. So there are so many solutions are there for that problem. So we have to find out all possible solutions for the given problem. So that problem is called as enumeration problem. Next, second one is decision problem. So a problem which requires either yes or no answer. So that problem is called as decision problem. So here yes means any feasible solution exists for solving a given problem or not. Suppose we can take one problem. So this problem can be solved. So that means it has a feasible solution or not. So that problem is called as decision problem. Third one is optimization problem. So in optimization problem, we have to search for the best feasible solution. So sometimes the optimization solution may require the maximum result. Sometimes the optimization problem may require the minimum result. So it depends on the given problem. We have to search for best optimal and best feasible solution in optimization problem. Suppose we can take a given problem. So this problem can be solved in many ways. Okay. So for that problem, we have to got so many solutions. So all the solutions for the given problem can be represented by using a tree called as state space tree. So state space tree describes all the solutions for a given problem can be represented. So that tree is called as state space tree. So it can be, in other words, a tree organization of the solution space is also called as state space tree. Suppose we can take a four queens problem. Okay, so four queens can be placed on 4x4 chessboard. Okay, so there are so many solutions are there. All the solutions for the four queens problem can be represented by using a tree called as state space tree. Suppose another example, we can take a given graph. So that given graph consists of 5 vertices. To color these 5 vertices, we have to use 3 colors. Okay, 5 vertices, 3 colors. So there are so many solutions are there to color all the 5 vertices in the given graph. So all the solutions can be represented by using a tree called as state space tree. In state space tree, we are using different types of nodes. So first one is a live node. And Second one is E node. Third one is dead node. So what is live node? A live node is a node which is generated, but its children are not generated. Only a node is generated, but its children have not yet generated. So that type of node is called as live node. Second one is E node. A live node whose children are currently being generated is called as E node. E node is also a live node whose children are currently being generated. Now we have to generate its children. So that type of live node is called as E node. Okay, what is the difference between live node and E node? In live node, a node is generated, but its children have not yet generated. But in the case of E node, a live node whose children are currently being generated. Now its children are generated. So that type of node is called as E node. Third one is dead node. So a node which is already expanded, but there is no use in the future. Okay. A node is generated whose children are already generated, but there is no use of that expansion of that node. So that type of node is called as dead node. So these three types of nodes are used in the state space tree. Next one is bounding functions. So bounding functions are determines the bounding values. So these bounding functions are used to kill live nodes without generating its children. Okay. So bounding functions are used to kill live nodes without generating its children. Suppose a node is there, its children are its children have not yet been generated. Okay, so at that time bounding functions are used to kill live nodes. So in backtracking we are using depth first search technique. Okay, suppose while solving a given problem we have to find out all possible feasible solutions. So at that time we are using depth first search technique. Okay, so the depth first search technique using bounding functions is called as backtracking. So backtracking uses the depth first search technique. Bounding functions are used to kill live nodes without generating any children. So next, there are two types of nodes in the state space tree. One is promising node and another one is non-promising node. So what is promising node? In state space tree, a node which is generated, its children are also generated by expanding this node. So then it can lead to a complete solution. So then it is called as a promising node. That means a node which is created that can be expanded by generating its children. So then it can lead to a complete solution to the given problem. Then that node is called as promising node. Second one is non-promising node. A node which is created or generated, it can be expanded by generating its children, but it cannot lead to a complete solution to the given problem. So then that type of node is called as a non-promising node. So a promising node can lead to a complete solution by generating its children. So that type of node is called promising node. A node which is created that can be expanded by generating its children, but it cannot lead to a complete solution to the given problem, is called as non-promising node. Next one. So each state in the solution state space tree defines a problem state. Okay, the path from root node to leaf nodes or other nodes defines a solution space. Okay, the path from root node to leaf node or other nodes defines a solution space. Each node in the state space tree, suppose this is a state space tree. So this is a state space tree. Each node defines a problem state. So this node represents a problem state. This node represents a problem state. This node represents a problem state. So the path from, this is a root node. The path from root node to leaf node or other nodes defines a solution space. Okay. Here there are two types of states are there. One is solution states and another one is answer states. Solution state is nothing but the path from root node to yes node. Okay, defines a state is called as solution state. So solution states are the problem state for which the path from root node to yes. So defines a tuple in the solution space. So here, so this node is also a problem state. So this is a root node. Okay. Solution state is nothing but the path from root node to yes node. It defines a tuple in the solution space. Okay. Next. What is answer states? Answer states are the solution states. Okay. The path from root node to yes node defines a tuple in the solution space, which is a member of the complete solution to the given problem. Okay. So it is in the case of solution state, it is not a member of the solution of the given problem, but answer state is a member of the solution to the given problem. So this is also path from root node to yes node, but it is a tuple in the solution space, but it is not a member of the solution to the given problem. In the case of answer state, the path from root node to yes node, it defines a solution space, but it is a member of the solution to the given problem. Okay. Here it is not a member of the solution to the given problem. So that is the difference between solution states, answer state. It is a solution state. It is also a solution state. But what is the difference? It is a solution state, but it is not a member of the solution of the given problem. Here, it is a solution state, but it is also a member of the solution to the given problem. So that is the difference between solution state and answer state. Next one is, what are the applications of backtracking? So backtracking technique can be used in many applications. So first application is n-queens problem. So here we have to place n number of queens on n by n chessboard such that no two queens are on the same row, no two queens are on the same column, no two queens are on the same diagonal. So by using these constraints, we have to place n queens on an n by n chessboard. So that problem is called as N-Crane's problem. Next, the sum of subsets problem. So here we can take a set S. Okay. So in the set S, we are given n numbers. Okay. M is the maximum value. So the sum of the given numbers is always less than or equal to the capital M. So that type of problem is called as sum of subsets problem. Next, graph coloring problem. So graph coloring problem is nothing but we have to color all the vertices of the given graph. No two adjacent vertices have the same color. So that problem is called as graph coloring problem. Next, Hamiltonian cycles problem. In Hamiltonian cycle is a round trip path. Starting from the starting vertex, we have to visit all the vertices in the given graph exactly once and returning to the starting state. So then it is called as a Hamiltonian cycles. So now these applications can be solved by using backtracking. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel name DIVVELA SRINIVASA RAO. Thank you.